Thank you. Do I remember the day I met Jesus? How could anyone forget that? To the world, it looked like I had my life all together. Inside, I was a mess of pride and fear and greed. I tried a lot of bad things, trying to make myself feel better about who I was, or that I tried to distract myself from the fear I fought every day, or to quiet the rage in my heart. None of it worked for long. But then a friend introduced me to Jesus, and he said, "Jesus can help you. Trust him." And that's what I did. I just trusted that this one that said he loved me and had the power to change me and had the grace to forgive me would do all of it.
I had been his follower for a long time, and I'd known him as my Savior. Then I was diagnosed with cancer. Suddenly, everything that I had believed about him was tested. Throughout the months of chemotherapy, surgery, and radiation, he was my provider, my healer, my everything. In the hardest moments, in the uncertainty of the long nights, and in the face of fear, I would speak his name, Jesus, and he was always there.
You are crowned with every crown. days, I was simply invisible to the world. On the worst, I was despised and shamed. Do you know what it's like to go through life without ever being touched by someone who cares about you? I was lied to, I was abused, used, but I was never listened to or cared for. Jesus changed all that. He loved me, and I loved him because I deserved absolutely nothing, and he gave me absolutely everything.
Holy One. Even the name Jesus gave me, Peter, means a rock. I love Jesus. I believed in everything he said and all that he did. I really thought I would follow him into any battle, even to death. But things didn't go down the way I thought they would in Gethsemane the night he was arrested. I tried to defend him, but he stopped me. He wouldn't fight. He surrendered. It shook me. And as I watched the soldiers, the mob, the Romans, I panicked. And then I denied I even knew him. The memory still hurts. But he forgave even that. He forgave me, and he didn't stop loving me.
Until death crashes into your world, until you're the one making funeral arrangements for that person that meant the world to you. Until you're the one walking away from that grave, headed home to that empty spot at the table, you don't know what you believe. Anointing. I was washed in his grace and overwhelmed with his love. He is real, and I know that what I believed in faith about his death and his resurrection was true.
Thank you.
overseeing his crucifixion, it was just another day on the job. You see, I drove him up that hill. I made sure the nails in his hands and his feet were strong enough to support the weight of his body. I could hear him as he spoke words of hope to the man suffering next to him, as he spoke words of love and compassion to his mother and her friend. When he asked his father to forgive those crucifying him, see, that was me. He was forgiving me when I was in the middle of torturing him. When he looked up at the sky and asked God why he had left him there to bear it all alone, by this time, even I was anxious for the end of his agony. Finally, with a loud voice, he cried out, "It is finished!" It was like someone turned out the lights on that hill. The ground, it shook. The sky, it seemed to disappear. Even in the darkness, I could see this was no ordinary man. Then the truth came to me like a bolt of lightning. This wasn't an ordinary man. This was the Son of God.
Where love and wrath run wild, there can here tonight, and we hope that the music has prepared you for the Lord's Supper, because this is the centerpiece of all of our worship services around here, just gathering around this table. We're to do this until Jesus comes back, and then we're going to be doing the Great Supper in heaven. And amen. Is that going to be one great worship service? Amen. This has been a good one, though, already. This has been fantastic. And we've been prepared for the big moment and to gather around this table. And so in just a moment, I'm going to pray and lead us in prayer. And I'm going to ask you to come forward for communion. If you haven't been here before, I want you to know that if you're in the center aisles, I want you to come to the center, line up and come down, and then go back to your row down the next aisle. If you're on the outside, start out by going to the outside, going to the Lord's Supper, and come back down that aisle. That way you're not running into each other, okay? And believe it or not, that does happen. We don't want that to happen. But we are so grateful for what we've heard so far. Why? Because it sings to us about the cross and about worshiping the Lord, lifting Him up, and remembering everything that He has done for us. All that we have, all that we will ever have, including heaven, is because of Him. Because of Him. And we praise and we honor the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Let's stand together and let's pray. Father, I am so grateful tonight for what we've already heard, because it has really set our minds to words how appreciative and how thankful we are for the grace and the blessing that Christ has brought to our lives because of His sacrifice. We know it all started with God the Father, His great love for people, Him wanting to save people and sending His Son to die for us. We realize that it was a terrible, terrible week when Jesus gave His life. The suffering, the torment He went through, and the pain that He suffered on the cross, and the separation that He had between Jesus and His Father, was something that was absolutely torturing and hurtful, Lord. And we are grateful for all of that. But because of that, today we have salvation in Christ. And we know, as Christians, that someday we're going to go to heaven because of what Jesus did. Until that comes, Lord, that day comes, we gather around this table to remember everything that Christ has given us. Thank You, Father. Thank You, Jesus, for all You've given us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
surrendering to him led to joy and freedom.
Because he's alive, no matter who I was, no matter what I've done, there is a place for me in his kingdom.
Because he's alive, I'm not broken and thrown away. I am valued and whole.
Because he's alive, I can be forgiven of my crimes, even my part in his death.
Because he's alive, death is not the end. I will see my loved one again.
Because he's alive, my failures are not my destiny. His strength is my courage, his love my hope.
Because he's alive, the healing I know now is but a glimmer of the ultimate healing I will know in his presence.
Because he's alive, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is the Lord, and you believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, then you will be saved.
Amen.
Great job. Fantastic job. All the smiling faces out there. That's a running joke with us. I'm always giving them a big grin, and they look back at me and grin back. So they just fantastic. Sounded great. Sounded wonderful. Just terrific. Are you going to do another performance in an hour? Is that what we're doing? Not a problem. They practiced a long, long time on this. They have had several hours of practice. We appreciate that so much. Practice makes it perfect, right? All right, all right. Fantastic. We want to thank Steve for all that he does. He wasn't a bit worried about it today. Not at all. He was not. He said to me about it at noon. He says, "I wish I could do it right now. Wish I could do it right now." And we want to thank the drama team too. The drama team. I never did like the Romans. Never did. They did a great job. That's terrific. A great addition to what we're doing here. And also the audio team back there behind me. They're always back there making sure we got batteries in our microphones, okay? And they changed this one tonight, so we'd have one that was green. It worked tonight. So I'm really grateful for that. But we really appreciate you coming tonight. And it's great to see all the smiling faces, but a lot some new faces tonight. And we want to just encourage you to come back and see us again. And then upcoming See Us Again is on Easter morning, on Sunday morning at 10:30 at the Big Ten, okay? And you may want to come a little early, okay? Because we only have 1,000 seats, all right? So we want you to be there. I want you to be part of that. Invite others to come. We still have some flyers there. You still got time to tell some people, hey, listen, you ought to come with me Easter. We're going to have a great time. We're going to have lots of parking. Sometimes you believe that we're not going to have enough parking. We have lots of parking. We're all prepared for you. We got lots of ice water out there that's going to be after service and lots of cookies. I've got 800 cookies waiting on you when you leave. Okay? And also, we're going to be neat to watch all the kids chasing the eggs out after the service. So please be part of that. Please be praying about that. A lot of people that are in this room are involved in it one way or the other. It takes several volunteers to do that. That service will last an hour, an hour and 10 minutes, I promise. And we're just looking forward to you being there. There's nothing like Easter morning. There's nothing like it. And I hope you're there. It's electric morning, and we're looking forward to it. And we want to thank everybody for getting us ready for that tonight. Thank you so much. Let's stand together and let's pray. Lord, I thank you so much for the work of the choir and Steve and the acting up the drama team and also our audiovisual people. Lord, it takes so much to make this happen. It takes several hours of work, lots of prayer, and lots of practice. And we thank you for that, Lord. And we pray, Lord, that you bless these folks that have done so much hard work on this. We're so grateful, Lord, that we can always get weekend when we will worship you. The gospel is presented that many people will change their hearts and follow Christ. Help us to make that a God-honoring event, and we pray, Lord, as you were there, many people will be there that need to be there, Lord. Thank you for your love, and thank you for this time we have together. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. Have a good night. Thank you.
Thank you.